Okay, I am back with a new video, and this is another one about raising children in the crafts and how crafty children can be, and just a couple of ideas of what they are interested in, where my children were interested in, and what they were able to do magically and energetically and etherically. And I showed this once about how to bring your cat back or something. This is a art thing she made when she was 12, and it represents the attic upstairs, and it has to do with her energy. This is my oldest daughter's energy, and what she wants to bring into her life, she would write down somewhere. She would hide it underneath pieces of paper and bark, and you know, she could set the clock there, up there, in what time frame she wanted to see her manifestation, you know, become real and enter this room, her life. So it's sand and leaves and bark and, you know, a couple of things that she got out of a fashion magazine. And but it is still the attic as it was when she was still living in my own home. It has sand from the garden. It has all kinds of personal, very personal items from her. And this is how she brought things into her life. If she wanted something into her life, in her life, when she wanted to manifest something, she would put it on this, you know, art piece or something. So manifestation seemed to be very easy for her. She is very talented and very passionate about the things that she does, and she got recently, a few days ago, got offered a second job at a university. So, you know, she has this thing, this magnet on her back or in her bones that attract nothing but great stuff, you know? She's so cool. She's really the she's amazing. And again, can children practice witchcraft? Can they, are they strong enough to practice witchcraft and work with energy? Yes, they can. She was, I think, the same age. I think, I don't know. She was also 12, 13, maybe, when she was initiated in Reiki by my husband, recent husband. I initiated her into angelic energies and so on and so on. So is that possible? Of course that's possible. Is it dangerous? Not at all. I don't know. It's not dangerous at all. So just have fun. Be flexible, have a good sense of humor, and let them create something that works for them. Their personal magical items. I showed my son's pillow. I showed my youngest daughter's wands. I showed this to you. Try to be creative and open-minded and not force certain things onto your children. I also learned her the art of vampirism, which was pretty crazy because the girl she had an eye on, you know, as for, you know, as a target, passed out, and that freaked me out a little bit because I was like, if you are strong enough to do this in just 3 minutes, then I don't know. But you have to be there and guide them, and you know, they choose what they want to do, they choose how they want to work, they choose what they want to work with, and then you just guide them through it safely. And then she started to charge her food with Reiki energetic energies, and then she started to charge her bed and her dolls and her Lego and her hamster, and you know, fun. See you next time. Bye.